Hello, YouTube PSP hacker AOD here, and I'm going to be showing the installation of my new Pioneer AVIX Z110BT into my 2008 Dodge Ram. I recorded this originally with my iPhone, and apparently I can't edit it or something. It doesn't work right or something. So anyway, basically here I have the new radio up here. And there's the old radio, which was whatever. It was the REC Nav radio by Dodge. It was an okay radio, but I wanted like amps and subs and new speakers and all that stuff. And I had an adapter for that, but it just didn't work out very well. It was kind of staticky, so I figured get a better radio. Plus, I had a cool thing called the lockpick installed on this radio, and basically. Dodge did an update to my car when I took it to the dealer and it pretty much blocked it out so I can't use it anymore. Yeah, here's all the cables and stuff right here that I got to install in there, or I did install. Yeah, fun stuff. I really am trying to just keep up with the video right now because I have to record my own audio because I can't edit the stupid video. Basically, a little bass knob in there. And first thing we're gonna do is remove the trim piece, and pretty much you can just get something, go underneath where my hand is, kind of pry it up, and the whole thing pulls off. But only thing is, on some RAMs, there's two screws at the bottom below the cup holders. I'm probably gonna point at that in a minute. Let's see, yeah, right there, those two screws. My truck didn't have them though, so yeah. Okay, basically, trim piece is off now, and you can see I have a lot of extra wires there. It's because I have the lockpick installed, which is that thing in my hand by Coastal Electronics, and basically called them up a couple times trying to figure out why it didn't work, and they totally just, oh, we don't know why, and all that good stuff, even though they do know, because finally I figured out, oh, it was the update that the dealer did, and they're like, oh yeah, we heard something about that, and they just send you in circles. They're a terrible company. Anyway, there's four screws to remove this radio, basically. 1, 2, 3, 4, basically around the sides. I guess I didn't point them out, but you can figure that out. Alright, so now I guess we have the radio out, and basically still got some extra stuff. There's all the old stuff took out. Yeah, I got some RCAs already run from my old adapter that was in there, and yeah, you can see them. And then I had some extra ground cable that I don't need anymore, so I've taken that out. And then you can see those zip ties that were supposed to hold the lockpick in place, that's coming out. And then those are the factory plugs I just showed, and it's gonna plug into this adapter I bought by Pack Audio, and I already spliced it all together to work with the radio. But that thing lets you keep some of the features because the car uses a stupid CAN bus system or whatever it is, and that screws up like screws up the car into thinking weird things if you don't have the right thing on there. So had to buy that little $70 adapter, but it works. Okay, so here the radio's in. Basically, that adapter worked good. Then there's my mic for the Bluetooth, and it's kind of up by my old mic that was in the mirror. That's what I was touching a second ago. And I ran the wire all the way down here, and it kind of drops down. And those are my antennas over there in the center for the navigation and the Sirius satellite radio, because I couldn't adapt to the stock one. All right, so I got my digital camera today, so I can actually use my own audio or whatever. So basically, here's the radio for the iPod. We'll click play on it. Got the pink iPhone as the iPod right in here. Artwork, you got all the playlist options and stuff. You got your satellite. You got your Bluetooth audio, then you control it from the iPhone. Alright, sorry about that a second ago. I had to cut it short, but.
Drop the ball, fucking y'all.